Hello, I'm Sebastian. Welcome to Nine Gnar Trees podcast. Today, I will summarize and review the book. In The Theory of Everything Else, A Voyage into the World of the Weird, author Dan Schreiber takes readers on a captivating journey through the most bizarre and intriguing corners of science and history. With a talent for uncovering the wonderfully weird, Schreiber delves into topics that traditional science often overlooks, presenting them in an accessible and engaging manner. This book promises to stretch the imagination and challenge perceptions, exploring phenomena that defy conventional explanations and scientific norms. Whether you're a science enthusiast or someone who relishes in the mysterious and the uncanny, The Theory of Everything Else offers a refreshing perspective that celebrates the oddities of our world. I will give you key takeaways from this book. Firstly, quantum mechanics and the nature of reality. One of the central themes in The Theory of Everything Else is quantum mechanics, a field dripping with enigmatic concepts like wave-particle duality, superposition, and entanglement. Schreiber skillfully simplifies these complex ideas without diluting their profound implications on our understanding of reality. The idea that particles can exist in multiple states simultaneously until observed challenges our everyday experiences and perceptions. Schreiber uses engaging anecdotes and historical contexts to unpack these principles, ultimately leading readers to question the very nature of reality and our place within it. His explorations serve as a gateway to discussing broader philosophical questions, such as determinism versus free will and the limits of human knowledge. Secondly, unexplained phenomena and scientific oddities. Schreiber dedicates a significant portion of the book to exploring unexplained phenomena that science has yet to fully understand or that reside on the fringes of mainstream research. From spontaneous human combustion to the placebo effect, he presents these topics through a lens of genuine curiosity and balanced skepticism. Schreiber not only recounts historical incidents and experimental results, but also evaluates the methodologies behind their study, encouraging a critical yet open-minded approach to such mysteries. This segment of the book is particularly fascinating, as it also discusses how such phenomena influence pop culture and societal beliefs, weaving a rich tapestry of science, history, and human psychology. Thirdly, the role of failure in scientific discovery. Another intriguing aspect Schreiber explores is the role of failure in scientific advancement. He argues that failure is an essential and often overlooked element of discovery. By examining infamous scientific failures and the lessons learned from them, Schreiber highlights how these moments are pivot points that drive progress. This discussion extends to the idea of scientific heresy, how initially rejected theories and ideas, like continental drift or the existence of meteorites, often push the boundaries of knowledge and lead to breakthroughs. This focus not only humanizes science, but also illustrates its evolving, self-correcting nature. Fourthly, the impact of technology on human perception. In discussing modern advancements, Schreiber reflects on how technology reshapes our perceptions and interactions with the world. From virtual reality to artificial intelligence, he investigates the implications of emerging technologies on our sensory experiences and cognitive processes. This topic is particularly relevant in the digital age, as Schreiber discusses the potential for technology to both expand and limit human experience, emphasizing the double-edged sword of technological dependency and the ethical considerations that accompany it. Lastly, the intersection of science and myth. Finally, Schreiber delves into the fascinating intersection of science and myth. He explores how myths, legends, and folklore often contain grains of truth and insights into the natural world. By dissecting well-known myths and their origins, Schreiber shows how these stories can actually inform scientific inquiry and vice versa. This area of the book not only enriches the reader's understanding of cultural narratives, but also underscores the role of storytelling in shaping scientific discourse and exploration. In conclusion, Dan Schreiber's The Theory of Everything Else is an essential read for anyone curious about the edges of scientific understanding and the mysteries that still elude us. It is particularly suited for readers with an interest in science, history, and the paranormal. By presenting complex concepts in an engaging and accessible way, the book invites readers to question and expand their views of the world. It's a reminder of the boundless curiosity that drives human progress and a celebration of the strange and unexplained. The insights gained from this book can encourage more open-mindedness and creativity in personal and professional life, making it a beneficial read for thinkers, creators, and anyone who appreciates the intrigue of the unexplained. If you would like to support Dan Schreiber, you can buy the book through the Amazon link I've provided in the podcast description. After reading the book, please let me know what you think and share your thoughts. See you around.